This is Terror House Radio with Matt Forney and Bryden Proctor.
Yeah, welcome to Terror House Radio episode number 52. I'm Matt Forney, your charming and loquacious host and the founder and editor-in-chief of Terror House Press. I'm joined by my co-host and producer, Bryden Proctor. How you doing, Bryden?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either. You know, it's not been a great day for me, but it'll be a good day tomorrow because I'm finally moving into an apartment, my first apartment in over a year. So I'm not going to be a homeless vagrant anymore.
Hanging out in dumpsters, waiting for women to walk down alleyways.
Yeah. You know, eating food out of the dumpsters. You know,
Dumpster Matt. Dumpster Matt. Everybody, chant along at home. Dumpster Matt.
Yeah, did you see that story out of Portland where they had the power outage, and a local Fred Meyer had to throw out a ton of food because it was spoiled, and to dissuade homeless people and Antifa from mobbing the dumpsters, they had to call the police, and everyone was mad about that.
Well, I mean, I can kind of see both ends though. I can kind of see both ends to it because, like, how spoiled was it? Because if it's like, we can't sell it anymore, that's one thing. But if it's like, you know, it's going to make somebody sick, I see the other one. Like, you know, because like they can't sell it. Like, even if it's still fine, they can't sell it anymore.
Yeah. There's legal considerations to have there. Well, I'm just looking from the perspective of Portland. In Portland, the homeless are a fucking plague. And the store obviously didn't want to encourage a bunch of homeless people to show up and, you know, scare off actual paying customers.
Yeah, and like I said, I understand both parts of it. You know, I understand both parts of it. One, because, like, I hate all the food waste that goes on, especially if there are a bunch of homeless, you know, junkies and shit like that. You know, so I understand, but it's, you know, your business. You don't want all those people hanging out doing that. I understand both parts of it. I don't have an answer for it. But no, I didn't hear about that. But it is a shame about all that food and all of those. All of it sounds terrible.
Yeah, I mean, in any other city, I probably would have taken the side of the homeless people. But I've lived in Portland, and I know how obnoxious the homeless people there. And like I said, Antifa also showed up.
Right.
So yeah, if Antifa are going to show up at a supermarket, then yes, the police are going to get involved.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, seems not good. Seems like a really dumb, kind of like modern fucking problem. You know, like, that's what I've been thinking about a lot recently. It's just like, okay, so pretty much everything just repeats itself, you know, throughout time and history and stuff like that. But we have some like pretty just modern ass problems, and it's that's a stupid one to have. It's like, oh, our fucking refrigerators, which are, it's incredible that those exist, went out. So now we have to throw out all this food, and we have to stop, like, these poor people from having food because we need to sell people who have just enough money to to shop at Meijer the same food. That's just a real modern, stupid problem to have. And I don't know. It's absurd. I don't like the world.
So what you're saying, Bryden, is that there's an eternal recurrence?
No, eternal recurrence is supposed to be a thought experiment. It's not supposed to be a real thing.
But modern problems. I mean,
and that's not what we're doing. Eternal recurrence is just say, it's like, hey, for I know you know, but for those of you who don't know, that's like at the end of your life, death is like, you want to do it again? You can't change anything, but you want to do it again? And you're supposed to say, this is supposed to be measurement of whether or not you have a life that's been worth fucking living, is you're supposed to say, yeah, give me another go. Now, that seems like a dumb fucking idea to me. I mean, the whole goal is to finish doing things. That's what I think, at least. So I want to be done being alive as soon as I can. But it seems like bullshit to throw out that food. I don't know. I'm kind of on there, kind of not on the side of business today, which is, you know, must have woken up on the left side of the bed.
Well, here's the big brain center solution. Maybe Fred Meyer could have just donated the food to a pantry or something.
Can't do it. They'll be held liable if the food actually is bad.
Oh, right, yeah.
Which, again, bureaucracy, that's a real fucking cool problem to have there. It's stupid bullshit. Like, it's just, give those poor people the food. I mean, but the thing is, one of them would have gotten sick. They would have sued. It's, you know, you can't, it's impossible to even be a nice person. That's how shitty the world is. Modernity is shit. Like,
now I'm visualizing, like, a homeless person in a court, just, you know, just stinking, wearing rags, with a really, really, a really, really small hat lawyer next to him. Your Honor, my client was given free food by Fred Meyer, and he got salmonella poisoning.
Is that Jewish guy from fucking New Zealand? What is that accent?
It's my approximation of a Jewish Florida accent.
That's fucking terrible, Matt. G'day, mate. Shalom, mate. What the fuck? Oh, wow. But yeah, no, that's exactly what would happen, though. So it's like, I understand both sides of it, but it does seem like the most reasonable thing would be to give those poor people the food. But the thing is, you can't do that. Like, you can't, because we live in a shit world. Because somebody would. I mean, absolutely. If somebody got sick from eating the spoiled whatever it is, they would have sued. Because we live in that type of shitty society that allows for that to happen. Like, it's, and the Antifa people would have been all behind them. You know, I'd be like, they're responsible for the, guarantee it. Because everybody's a fucking asshole.
The bourgeois capitalist pigs intentionally handed out tainted food so that they could harm the working class.
Right. Yeah, the working class almost. Yeah. You know, it's, and you got to think about it too. Especially there, I'm sure there's a lot of recently homeless in that area. And, you know, like, dude, a lot of people straight up have definitely, you know, coming on hard times, need some damn food. And then there you go. They go around throwing out food. So that seems fucking terrible. But then you do have to think about what you just said. That's how they would react to, you know, if somebody did get sick from it. Every single thing in life, Matt, is a no-win situation. There's no fucking winning. We've bogged ourselves down with too much bullshit. I don't know. Maybe it's... we need some... something. So I want to say self-reliance, but I don't want to sound like that. I just... Do you have it? I mean, what's an answer to that?
We need a great cleansing.
No, that sounds violent and fucking terrible.
Well, I mean, I didn't... cleansing is a very neutral word. You can attach whatever significance you want to it.
No, it kind of has a lot of... It sounds bad. Maybe...
It could be moral cleansing. Moral cleansing.
Moral cleansing?
You need a moral cleansing.
That also still sounds... Cleansing, yes. Just sounds a... Just kind of runs a shiver up the spine, doesn't it? You know? Like, unless it's a soap commercial, it's like the cleansing power of Dove soap, you know, then it's fine. But unless you're talking about soap, it just kind of sounds like a word you don't want to hear on the radio, you know? Like, attention, we are commencing the cleansing now. Like, I know that's not what you meant, but
it's a moral genocide.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it sounds like.
We need moral war crimes.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds bad, you know? Just sounds bad, like, moral this, cleansing that, purity. Like, any of those things sound pretty bad. They shouldn't, I guess, but the wrong people say the certain things, and then it kind of leaves a bad taste in your mouth for generations upon generations.
Yeah, speaking of radio, Rush Limbaugh died last week, and that was a sad moment.
Yeah, I did a 9 and some hour, because I'm taking a break from streaming, but, you know, I did a 9 and some hour stream, you know, just trying. I mean, it obviously doesn't do the man justice. He was like a fucking hero to me. I was real sad. I mean, we watched like a couple of the Rush to Excellence tour videos and just some like one thing when he was back in New York on C-SPAN, like a full 2 hour thing of him doing the show. You know, I mean, it was good. It was good. I mean, I knew he was going to be dying soon when he hadn't been on.
He didn't have much longer.
Yeah, he hadn't been on for 2 weeks, you know, and it was like on the 17th, I flipped over to the station and it's his wife talking and I'm like, oh no. And I, you know, I said this on the stream and I'm not embarrassed to say this, but I pulled over to the side of the road and I cried a little bit and went about my day. But didn't cry on stream, luckily, though. Got real drunk. Didn't cry on the stream. I feel good about that. But
I salute you.
Yeah, man. He was a real important person, and he was just real important to me and pretty much anybody that has ever had a podcast, you know. Rush was a great guy, and he'll be missed by, you know, certain people. Other folks were real happy about it. And like, I don't get mad that they were like, haha, Rush Limbaugh's dead. I'm like, yeah, so is Ruth Bader Ginsburg is still dead, shithead. So crabs. Like, it's fine. But so that stuff doesn't bug me. It just, you know, him, like, what am I supposed to listen to now? You know?
Well, I mean, they were posting highlight reels of stuff he did over the years. That was pretty awesome. One of the funniest things was that apparently at one point Rush was he had a segment where he would read the names of people who died from AIDS. That was fucking hilarious.
He only did that twice.
Really?
Yeah.
The way they made it sound like he was like a regular feature.
No, dude, he did that like twice. I mean, it was not like
it's still funny.
Yeah, I mean, the stuff that they did, that they were like, look, here's the horrible things he said. I'm like, that shit's hilarious. He was really funny, dude. And, I mean, how is that any different than, you know, Colbert or Kimmel getting on the air and, you know, cracking these jokes about, like, you know, this, that, and the other about, you know, any right-wing person? I mean, they're jokes. I mean, sure, they mean them, but it doesn't bother me. And it shouldn't bother... You know, whatever. Rush Limbaugh was a fucking the big voice on the right. He was the best, and he'll be sorely missed by those of us that listened to him for years and years. But what can you do? You know, I mean, he lived for a long time with stage 4 fucking lung cancer because it was February of 2020. When he was on the radio and he was like, hey, I got fucking stage 4 lung cancer. And I cried then too. which, like, you know, parasocial relationships are fucking weird. But yeah, I'm still bummed out about it. Like I sent you that clip of Biden accidentally dropping an N-bomb because he's just stuttering. And I thought, like, man, Rush would have fucking played that today. And he would have been able to play that on the radio, and it would have been hilarious. He would have loved it. He would have loved that clip, you know. So I don't know. We'll see. Nobody's going to ever replace Rush Limbaugh, but we'll see how talk radio fares.
Talk radio is probably going to be gone in 5 years. I mean, Rush was the big, big guy holding it all together, you know. And who are they going to replace him with? Ben Shapiro?
I kind of suspect that as far as like the 12 o'clock time slot goes, I kind of suspect it might go to Glenn Beck, but...
Oh, Beck. Beck is no Limbaugh.
No,
Beck
of
is,
course
Beck
not.
Is, Beck sucks.
I mean, I listen to Glenn Beck every now and then because I like stew, you know, and it's on. I'm like, okay, let's see what these nerds are up to. And they do funny stuff. Like Hannity's never funny.
Hannity is the pits. I mean, I'll admit Beck has his moments. Hannity is the pits.
Yeah, he's just he's never funny. He's never like, you know, doing bits or whatever. And like Glenn and Stu will do bits. I mean, it's like milquetoast fucking weird Mormon bullshit, you know. But for talk radio, fine. It is what it is. And it's like, okay, whatever. But yeah, Hannity's not funny. Levin is not funny on purpose. Man,
I find Levin unbearable.
Ugh. Yeah, I'm going to start the fucking Darth Forney with the goddamn vapes right into the mic.
I wasn't vaping then.
Oh, you're just breathing, you fat fuck.
I was...
any second now, I'm going to hear the rustle of a fucking Cheeto bag, and then... You're getting the fucking dust off your fucking sausage-ass fingers.
I've got a ball of phlegm at the back of my throat.
That's not phlegm. That's come because you're gay! Pew, 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 pew. Got him, got him. Burn of the week!
Terror House Radio, 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 radio.
I'm going to make all those fucking drops eventually, dude. It's going to be unbearable as shit. It's going to be real bad. Every single time. We just turn it to a whole morning zoo shit. I'll only do it when we have guests too. So like somebody's just like, oh, I'm here to plug my book or whatever. I'm just playing fart sounds the whole fucking time.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, but yeah, getting back to the subject, I find Levin unbearable because of his fucking voice. You know, he's basically Diet Coke Michael Savage, you know, who Savage is, you know, he's off the air now and he's been phoning it in for years.
Yeah, what really happened with Michael Savage? Because he just got kicked off of all of his stuff. I know, I'm pretty sure he still has a podcast, right?
Yeah, they decided to, cut his show to 1 hour. And then have to do a podcast, and then they got rid of the 1 hour that he was doing on radio, so now it's just a podcast. He claims he's under a gag order from Cumulus or whatever that he can't talk about it, but my guess basically is that they decided to retire him and replace him with Ben Shapiro, because Shapiro got the Savage had the 3 p.m. slot on Cumulus, and Ben Shapiro got that slot after Savage was booted.
I mean, he could be under a gag order. Cumulus is rough. I mean, anybody that like insinuates even that there's indiscrepancies. See, we got to be careful on YouTube too. Indiscrepancies with a certain election that didn't happen in the year 2000. That like they're getting on people for that shit.
Really?
Oh,
I
yeah.
Mean, that's. I mean, there's really no such thing as a good radio company, but God, that sucks.
Oh yeah. I mean, it makes you wonder. Like, why are they? Why is everybody going out of the way to be like, hey? Don't even mention, like, it's an odd thing. 40% of the country believes it. Like, what the fuck? 40% of the country believes something.
40% of the country believes it, and that 40% is like 90% of the people who listen to these shows.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you know, well, I was gonna say, like, over at Terror House, we don't like tell our customers not to read, but I do all the time, so that's not a very good point. But that's, you still shouldn't do that if you want to be a successful, you know, company. Because like Fox has been kind of not doing so hot after they've kind of just drifted slightly to the left, just a tiny, tiny bit, enough to make all the, you know, the rabid Trump red hat people kind of flip the fuck out. They're just mad about everything though. But it's, yeah, I don't know. I just, what a dumb and quick way to just kill your business. I think that they hope that they'll just get new customers and kind of see more like in the longer term, the, what are you doing? In the longer term that those will be, you know, like all the old people that listen to talk radio will die off. And all the old people that watch Fox News will die off, and they'll have, you know, they'll be able to bring in new customers who believe more, you know, what's sold to everybody, this like progressive stuff. So maybe it's not a bad business move at all. I mean, maybe that's literally what they're doing. I don't know. I couldn't get a job at any of those places if I tried.
Well, you're thinking about it too rationally. The simple reality is that they don't care about any of that. They care about power and controlling the flow of information.
I'm pretty sure these people care about money.
They already have all the money they could possibly need.
That's, I mean, not enough. You
know, no, they don't care. This was all purely political because they already have a fucking stranglehold. Okay, you know, you've got Fox, you got CNN, you got MSNBC. They have a stranglehold on cable news. OANN or Newsmax is never going to fucking compete. And you know what? If they, you know, if it looks like Newsmax is going to overtake Fox, and all this, what's going to happen is like boop. Yeah, Newsmax banned from YouTube. Boop. YouTube, Newsmax has their URL seized, their domain hosting canceled. Boop. Newsmax is suddenly dropped from all these cable carriers. This is how an oligopoly works. They're willing to forego increased profit to maintain the power that they have.
Yeah, I just gotta think that there's a lot of financial planning going on, a lot of money stuff going on that isn't talked about as much.
I mean, consider this, Bryden. The technology for cell phones, for, you know, wireless communication, was invented in the 1940s. However, it was suppressed by AT&T and other landline phone companies because they saw it as threatening to their monopoly.
Yeah. I mean, that's fair. So that also, again, comes down to what?
It comes down to them wanting to maintain their monopoly and their power.
And
even though they...
What's the purpose of monopoly?
Make money.
Make money, motherfucker! Like, I think it comes down to that a lot more than people give it credit for. Because that's a hard thing to be, like, exciting to kind of sell. It's not even a good podcast. It's not even, like, a good thing. It's something that everybody kind of inherently, quote-unquote, knows is that everything is about money. But, and there's a lot of just, like, you know, I'm a rich person. I should be able to shape the world. Guaranteed. These people think they're the smartest guys on the whole planet because they're rich. That's how you measure success. That's what we have in our social heroism. That's it. If you've got a lot of money, clearly you're smarter than everybody else because you have a lot of money. That's what we kind of all agreed to. They want to shape the world. They've got their own MO and stuff like that. But I think a lot of it is, how do you get everybody else to team up with you? These guys all think that they are the son of God himself, right? And they alone can solve. You get them all teamed up by going like, hey, here's how we make the most money and get the biggest return on our investment. This is what we do. In the long term, progressivism and all of that shit seems like it, until it doesn't, wins. You know, it just keeps going in one direction until it doesn't, and then it's a catastrophe, and then you end up with the other end of things also being terrible. Freedom is never allowed in this mix, except for a small period of time, once, and that was it. But yeah, I think that's how you get people to team up. You're like, we can make all this damn money together. So I think a lot of it has to do with that old generation is going to die off, and who are we going to sell our shit to? Because the boomers are going to be replaced with the Gen Xers, and they are just a bunch of obnoxious pieces of shit.
I'm not going to be lame by believing in stuff. That's Gen X.
Yeah, Gen X actually sounds pretty fucking cool the way you described him. Believing in shit is fucking gay, dude.
Okay, nihilist.
Okay, fucking Matt Forney. I don't know what to call you.
I win that one. But anyway, yeah, Gen X is fucking terrible.
Better than millennials.
Well, I mean, I don't know. That's debatable.
Like, the only generation worse than us are the fucking Gen Z nerds, who I just don't understand these damn kids. I don't understand these damn kids. I don't want to. It's not even like, oh, your damn music's terrible. Besides the Billie Eilish song, I hate that You're Not My Friend song. That one's just horrible. Her other stuff is not my taste, but it's not as bad. I'm Not Your Friend or whatever is the... The music is bad and dull. The lyrics are nonsensical. It's fucking... absolutely bad, and people like it just because it's her and she's really popular. It's not even the TikTok lip syncing shit. It's the fact that all these motherfuckers, like we did, I'm sure we did, you know, walk around as if they're like, well, clearly I have the answers to things. People are poor. Why don't you just print more money and give everyone $1 million and then everyone will be a millionaire? It doesn't. You know, I don't even know what is up with this Helen Keller never existed shit. I don't know if they found out she was a communist yet or not. I don't know.
I love how every time we get on this topic, we just reveal how old and crotchety we are.
I don't give a shit. I'm 33. I'm old. I'm crotchety. I'm not even old. That's another thing that I hate about this. 33 was not considered old when, like, I knew guys that were 33. It was not considered old. Now it's considered old. The last time 33 was considered old, people were dying at 40.
That's a myth, actually.
That's a myth, actually. Matt Forney, every time you try to fucking say something like that, that's a myth, actually.
Well, it is. The reason why the average age in, oh, I don't know, Manoa was 33 wasn't because people died at 33. It's because so many fucking newborns died at birth that it skewed the numbers hugely. People back then, they lived to around 60, 65. Not too different from today.
I hope you get dysentery.
But yeah, going back to that, I mean, I never listened to Billie Eilish. But so far, what I can tell is that Zoomer music really isn't that different from millennial music. Like, it's almost identical. Yeah. Remember that Pale Waves band that you played on stream?
Yeah.
There's no difference between that. That shit I could have been listening to 10, 15 years ago.
I mean, the sound of it's a little more crisp. Like, the synth of it and stuff is a little more crisp. Like, the synth sound, it's a little different, but not really. You know, not really. A lot of it is just the same shit. But I really don't like that fucking Billie Eilish song. Because it's like, I'm not your friend. I think therefore I am. And there's like 8 lyrics in it. And the whole song sounds like, duh, ba-da-da-ba-da-duh. Meanwhile, you know, Billie Eilish is like white or Jewish or something like that. But she's, you know, pale complexion. Meanwhile, you got my girl Doja Cat over here. She's awesome. I like that Say So song. That's funky as hell. She's all right. I can deal with some Doja Cat. I don't like this fucking Billie Eilish stuff one bit. And she looks like Lil Xan. You know the rapper? She looks like him. It's a weird, I don't know what phenotype that is, but I think it's just kind of mediocre shit music. That's the phenotype.
Plus, you can tell that she's been molested every single day of her life.
Yeah, she grew up rich. Of course she did. I mean, that's a sad truth to it. It's fucking horrible. I love Ariana Grande, but look what they fucking did to her. She's all kinds of messed up.
You love Ariana Grande. Okay.
Yeah, she makes great songs.
How much cum have you drunk today, Bryden?
Oh, about half as much as you, faggot. I like Ariana.
I don't know, she's fucking weird. Mostly I think it's fucking weird that she's trying to pass herself as Latina when she's Italian.
I don't know if she's ever said that or whatever. I don't pay attention to the woman.
Well, she's never said it, but like her fucking appearance is, look up early pictures of her. She's like a typical like Italian, you know, blonde chick. And now she's all tanned and she looks like she just got apprehended by ICE.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I don't care about any of that because why would I care what some fucking 20-something-year-old pop artist has to say about anything or is? I think the songs are catchy. You know, I mean, I'm still mad. She killed Mac Miller, bro. So I'm still pretty pissed about that.
Well, there's also that demerit and the fact that her most famous song is ripped off of, Christ, what's that song from the fucking 80s? Let's Get Physical? Yeah, she ripped that off.
Wait, which song?
Side to side.
Oh, yeah.
It's a metaphor for having sex.
Oh,
and
it's a pretty explicit song. It's awful. Yeah.
And like the Olivia Newton-John song, Let's Get Physical, the music video, you know, makes it all about, oh, it's actually about working out.
Well, you know, it is what it is. I just think the songs are catchy. I mean, I don't have to... Like, look, nobody's going to be motherfucking David Bowie. Nobody's going to be Daniel Johnston. Nobody is Conor Oberst, who is really petered off and sucks.
Nobody's going to be St. Vincent.
I don't know who that is.
You might like her music. She's probably my favorite contemporary musician.
I don't really care too much about these people, but I like some of the songs, man. I like some of the songs, but you know, these kids still got to get off my fucking lawn. By which I mean, you know, my live stream channels or anywhere I'm on the internet. I ban them, dude. Man, I ban them. If they're under 25, I ban them.
You're in order to comment on Brian's streams going forward, you're going to have to show ID.
I mean if I hear somebody's under the age of 25, it's like, you're on fucking notice. You better be a real cool guy that appreciates your fucking elders, dude, because I can't do it. I don't give a shit about, because the thing is, like, I've come to the conclusion that every 20-year-old has like the same set of thoughts. And, you know, like I remember being that agent, I had those same set of thoughts, you know. You come to these like same fucking conclusions and all of that. And it's like, actually, I'm from the older people congregation, and that won't work. It's actually a dumb fucking idea. And man, I can't wait for you to just in a few more years to realize you're not at all important. Like, how unimportant do I can't wait for it. How unimportant do like old people realize that they are? You know, I can't wait. To be like, oh, I knew I wasn't important. Because, like, if you've, you know, if you're 77 years old, you're like, yeah, that's pretty much everything I'm going to do in my life. If you're 20, your whole life is ahead of you, and you're like, I can do anything. You can't. You probably can't. Even if you're really good at it, you probably can't. Because it takes skill, connections, and on top of that, luck. So you probably still can't, even if you work very hard. But give it your all. But when you're 20, the whole world's in front of you. When you're my age, you're like, okay, maybe I'll give up on my loftier dreams of like being a professional comedian. Now I just kind of like to get my brakes fixed. So I'll go do that. And maybe I'll own a home someday in the shithole hellscape country that we have, that it's become in my lifetime. So I imagine by the time I'm like 70, if I make it, I'm going to go like, oh, this is, I don't know. I'll just shit my pants. Fuck it.
Brian, you're the exact personality type who's going to buy a sports car when you turn 40 to compensate for your shrinking dick.
If I have the money, yes. And if I have enough money, I would get a giant penis implant, dude. I'm talking like a loaf of bread. Fucking Wonder Bread size, just like, and I'd start wearing Speedos. Like, I'm getting kicked out of places, you know. And there's lawsuits. There's lawsuits, Matt. I'm like, why was I removed? They don't make Speedos. They don't make pants that can hold my mass. And you know, that would be great. And then that's how I get my, you know, all of my money from there. And I don't know. I'd probably just blow it on like starting a competing book publishing company, because I imagine we'll be on the outs by then. Let's call mine like Scary Cabin, you know.
Now, there's actually some dumb bitch who hates us who always refers to Terror House as Spooky House. So you can go with Spooky House.
That's pretty cool. I like Spooky House. What's wrong with that? Is that an insult? That's like pretty cool. I'm gonna do a spin-off.
No, it's an attempt. It's an attempt to avoid our ire. You know, like I'm gonna notice or care.
Well, you clearly noticed.
Well, I noticed it because it was so fucking dumb.
I don't know. I think it's pretty sweet. I'm gonna go hang out with her.
Well, imagine if someone who was obsessed with you just obsessively referred to you as Pryden and Proctor.
Oh, I'm sure somebody does.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You think like, well, you're fucking retarded.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't know. I think all those people are pretty fucking weird. Cause like, I mean, maybe I just can't see it. You know, like maybe my self-esteem is like so low, but like, I look at like me, anything I've ever done, like artistically or you know, podcastily, because I don't know if a podcast is art or not. Terror House, anyone I've like ever spoken to in my entire life or like done podcasts with, you know, like the Not Funny guys and like all of the my whole comedy, everything. And I'm like
the paintings you've done,
yeah, paintings,
the money shots you've taken to the face.
Yeah, good one, Matt. So I look at that. I look at that, and I just, like, to me, it just feels so fucking unimportant that I can't believe that anyone would ever, you know, take the time to, one, pay attention to it at all, to, like, give it any type of, like, oh, I listen to Terror House Radio. But, like, you know, the few of you that they are. But for anyone to be upset, I don't spend my part of the day worrying about what jackass drunk people are doing on the fucking internet. Because I assume it's something stupid. You know, like, I don't, you know, it makes me wonder if, like, these same types of people, every time they have to, like, drive past a trailer park, just glare at it. You know, because that's how I feel. And maybe you probably don't.
They probably do, and they probably grit their teeth while doing it.
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. I just don't see how anyone could feel. I just don't know why. Like, I mean, mission accomplished, basically, is like to get under somebody's skin. But like, I just don't understand, like how anyone could be like, did you know that they're publishing fucking Lauren Southern erotica? Like, how is that? I don't know how that would get under anyone's skin. I don't know.
That was one of the more popular pieces we ran, actually.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It's not that I'm like better than anybody, you know. Like, things get under my skin. Like, I'm fucking real mad at the Taco Bell app all the time. But like, am I wrong here? It just seems weird.
What the hell did the Taco Bell app ever do to you?
It's fucking always breaking, Matt. It doesn't work. It, like, won't take my fucking card, and, like, I can't do the different... I can't even use any of the different... It's just fucking broken. And they won't fix it.
Yeah, that didn't make sense.
Yeah, they're the fucking Yum Corporation. You'd think that they would goddamn fix it. I'm trying to give you money. That's the most frustrating thing.
Have you ever considered the revolutionary method of just going to the restaurant and ordering?
Yeah, that's what I have to do, Matt. I'm not abstaining from Taco Bell. It's just I like to be able to do it because I like to customize. Because, like, I won't go into one if I have to, like, order through the drive-thru or anything. I use the kiosk, all right, because of the customization that I have to do, you know, because, like, I don't want to risk it. You know, because I got to get my cheesy gordita crunch, okay? But that's got to be refried beans instead of the meat. And I don't want the black beans. The black beans are not a good substitute. If you click the vegetarian thing on it, it automatically just defaults to black beans. I'm not into that. I want the refried beans. So I got my refried beans. And somebody's going to fucking leave a comment or something and be like, actually, talk about refried beans have pork in them or something. And that wouldn't shock me. I hope not, but it wouldn't shock me. And if that's the case, I'm probably still going to do the refried beans, but, you know, I gotta do that. I gotta make sure I get my onions out of my bean burrito, dude. Like, it's, you know, it's a lot to have to say through a drive through if I'm doing a big order, you know?
Yeah. I mean, you know, these custom orders are absolute pain in the ass to do without the kiosk, but yeah, you like the refried beans. Like, how often do you eat this?
Not very often.
Okay, because I was going to say, you must be farting so much that, like, there's permanent stink lines around you, like Pepe Le Pew.
No, I mean, I would eat it more. It's just, it's, like, further away at my new place than, you know, than my old place. So it's like, if I'm out and about and I see a Taco Bell, yeah. I mean, it's still my favorite fast food place, but it's just, it's far away. I'm not eating much fast food these days, which is...
Probably a good thing.
No, I don't know. I was eating a lot of it pre-COVID, you know. I was always eating at fast food places. And now it's just, I don't know. They took going to grocery stores, really. They took the fun out of that for me, going to get food at places. They just took the fun out of it. Because, like, people want to say, act like Florida is some, like, bastion of fucking freedom. It's really not, you know. Like, yeah, things aren't locked down, but, you know, there's still... masks, there's still, like, social distance fucking things that people do. There's still, not that I want people all crowded up on me or anything, but it's like, it makes, you know, standing in line weird. You know, and this is the most annoying thing, is like one door, so like double doors going into anywhere, one door is always fucking locked.
They do that. Yeah. I've seen that shit in Mexico too. I've seen them do it with, like, fucking open air, like the, you know, the stores that have, like, the open entry, you know, the big huge hole, you know. They'll tell you to enter on the right side and leave on the left side. I saw a Little Caesars, you know, with a double door. You had to enter on the left and leave on the right. And if you mixed it up, the clerks would get pissed.
See, it's just fucking weird. Well, I swear to God, we're in a fucking Kafka novel, dude. Like, this is, this, it's it. Is this not the, that is all of these fucking, I don't know, conditions, whatever you want to call them, mandates, any of that. And, like, even in Florida, how, like, they're just followed even though they're not enforced thoroughly, or whatever, in a lot of places. It's, this is the definition of Kafka-esque, right? Am I wrong? Am I using that wrong, or...
It's, well, it's ridiculous. I mean, think about it. You know, it's like the, you know, double doors, only being allowed to use the right one to enter. How is that fucking rational? It's not.
It doesn't at all stop fucking airborne viruses. Like, it just, it doesn't make any sense. And if anything, it's forcing more people into a smaller space. It just, it doesn't make any sense. I really hate that. Because anytime I go into a place or whatever, you know, it's, one of them will be locked. It's double doors and one of them's fucking locked. And I'm always that jackass. And I'm sure this happens to everybody else a million times, you know, whenever you do it. Like, I'd say probably 1 out of 4 times, I guarantee this happens to me and everyone else. One of those motherfucking doors is locked.
It happened to me a couple times in Mexico City. In Guadalajara, you don't see that shit. Nobody here really cares.
I went into this, I told you about this, went into this fucking, like, Latin, they call it a grocery store, but it's, like, pretty clearly, like, a gas station that doesn't have gas, and they also, like, you know, just sell beer. I mean, I don't know.
The technical term for that is a bodega, but continue.
Do they have bodegas here? Maybe. Whatever it is, bodega. I don't know. But they're playing, they weren't really playing that, but it all sounds like that to me. But they're playing that, it's all loud and shit, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna get a beer, and nobody's wearing masks. It was fucking incredible. And then fucking 20 feet away is a gas station, everybody masked the fuck up, going in and out, like, people in their cars wearing masks going, it's the dumbest bullshit. And then anybody that's like, hey, you know, the reason we gotta keep wearing masks because people aren't wearing masks, the majority of people are wearing masks, the majority are. You're going to go and shut down the bodega then? I mean, isn't that racist? It's frustrating. I feel like I'm going fucking crazy. I really wish they would have just said something consistent. Because if they would have been saying something consistent for a year, then I would go, oh, well, okay, those are, you know, I need clear rules. You can't just keep changing them all around. Because on top of it not making sense, it changes all the fucking time. It's dumb. This is a Kafka-esque fucking country. The United States of Kafka-erica.
The United States of the castle.
It's frustrating. I get fucking anxious leaving the house now. I'm like, who am I going to fucking argue with now? Because, like, this is, everybody's gone crazy. Waiting for roving street gangs. Warriors, come out and play. I'm waiting for it. No maskers, come out and play. They're going to start beating us with bats. I promise you.
Yeah, you know, but at least a couple of years, you know, not wanting to wear a mask will be a federal crime.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, dude. I think they're going to fuse it to your fucking face. They're going to be like, look, I know you've had 18 shots of the vaccine. It seems like now you're probably going to be docile enough that we're going to need to fuse this to your face. What happens if I take off the mask? It would be painful. Oh, God. At least we'll look like Bane. That'll look sweet.
Yeah, I don't feel any anxiety because, like I said, like, nobody fucking cares. The only time I have to wear a mask is if I, you know, ride an Uber. And that's just some stupid bullshit. You know, worldwide corporate policy. Nobody here gives a fuck. I mean, the minimum wage, even in Mexico City, I saw it's like 7-Elevens with those, the arrows on the ground indicating the direction you're supposed to go when you enter the store. Nobody enforced that shit. They don't have the fucking energy. The minimum wage worker's busy worrying about how he's going to pay his bills and shit. He's not going to get up in the face of someone who's not wearing a mask when they enter.
You know when you know where they have, like, lines that you have to walk on and walk in a certain direction? Prison!
Oh, yeah.
It's the fucking prison planet, dude.
Like, there's nowhere to run.
By the way, do you know where the term lockdown originated? Where that comes from? Prison.
Oh, it's true. It's fucking true.
By the way, that Chinese thing about anal swabbing for coronavirus tests, that's going to be mandatory on in American airports by the end of the year.
Oh yeah, I can see that. I mean,
you're going to have some creep stick a Q-tip up your ass in order to fly. And then you'll need it in order to, you know, ride a train or a bus, and then you'll need it in order to go to the grocery store.
Flights to and from Miami, just fucking way up. Everywhere else down, but to and from Miami, guys lining up, going, "Oh, give me another round."
And I'm pretty sure that, you know, the Chinese aren't even really doing that. They just made it up. Like, at this point, I'm sure they're just fucking, let's see if the Baizuos actually believe this. Oh, they do. They're so fucking stupid.
Well, I mean, they made it up. I swear to God, all those videos that came out of China at the beginning of people, like, falling over in the street and shit, that was fake. That was fucking fake.
That never happened anywhere else.
Yeah, that was fucking fake. They did a damn good job. I mean, it was one of those things, like, Nietzsche talked about this, like, how you should, you know, have respect for your enemies and, like, you know, all of that. I have some pretty big respect for fucking China for the way they pulled this shit off. They were like, we have lost a trade war. What are we going to do? And then they're like, let's get on Twitter and then we will send all of these tweets praising the Wuhan-style lockdown to Italy. And then there you go with that. And then the videos, all of that. I mean, it's fucking impressive. It's a lot of respect. They deserve to take over the fucking world, dude. They totally deserve it.
Well, I mean, Sun Tzu wrote that the best way to win a war is to not fight it and, you know, make your enemy capitulate without fighting. That's exactly what they did.
Yeah, I mean, shit, they deserve it. They deserve it. I'm just saying, like, whenever the Chinese come, I'd probably actually get along with the Chinese, spare their eating habits, you know. I'd be like, stop frying dog. Like, I don't like that because I'm, you know, don't eat meat. It's not that I, like, particularly like dogs. I just think meat is wrong. But I bet I would get along with the Chinese a lot more because I'd be like, look, at least they have a fucking clear and defined set of rules you're supposed to live by.
And also, they don't wear masks and they don't do lockdowns. Like, they'll probably come over and be like, okay, white man, you can take a mask off.
Yeah, dude. I mean, seriously. Yeah, it's by the end of it all, they're going to be in the whatever Chinese advisor room and you're gonna be like, they will treat us as liberators and they'll invade. Oh man. Yeah, that'll be a rough day. Whatever. I'm gonna be fucking dead. Like, I don't even wanna fight absurdism. I just look at it and embrace it for what it is, which is the biological functionality of everything that is on this planet. If consciousness is God completing his suicide, then all of this, like, around us is just something that was inevitable. Like, all of this is just inevitable given the circumstances. You know, it's kind of like when you ever, like, sit on the ground for a little while, like, you know, like out on the grass, and then you get ants crawling all over you and shit.
Oh, yeah, that's happened.
That's kind of what it all is. Like, it's just, you're just an animal, you know, and all of this is just a weird thing. It's not that it's unnatural. Nothing that happens is unnatural or out of place. It's just the logical end to the previous series of events. So, I mean, it's just not a thing that's easy to comprehend, because where do you get off thinking you're supposed to comprehend anything? You know, like, it's other dogs aren't trying to ponder why some homeless person kicked them. You know, they're just upset that it happened. People need to stop pondering why or something is or how to fix it, because that's how we got into this problem to begin with, is people trying to fix shit. They should have just woke up and been like, I need to eat an apple. That should be it.
I'm just an animal searching for a home.
Yeah. You want to do Terror House news? Because I got pissed.
Go right ahead. Yes, Terror House news. Broken Uterus by Kai Jenten, translated by Xenon, is out now. If you're listening to this, you missed the sale, unfortunately, but you can still buy it at terrorhousepress.com and on Amazon and elsewhere. Next week, we've got Spectres of Saturn by Patrick Kilgore is out on March 5th. We will be having Patrick on the show next week. He's a funny guy. He's one of the writers we nominated for a Pushcart Prize last year, and he also contributed to Ending Bigly, The Many Fates of Donald Trump, edited by Bill Marchant. And in March, we also got we got some other big things. Any day now, we will be releasing the audiobook version of With Light and Dust, read by Xenon, co-authored by Xenon and Fishlu. And next month, we will also be our books will be publishing, in addition to Spectres of Saturn, will be Heart Killer by Andy Nowicki and Bergman's Island and other Bergman's Island and Other Poems by Ralph Munday. Check it out. Terror House has many, many great things around the bend. Are you back, Bryden?
Yeah.
He is not back. Here. Cool. That was perfect. Perfect timing.
Yeah. Yeah. It would have been exactly perfect, but I decided to readjust my chair pillow because it's been years and I still haven't just coughed up the money for a new fucking chair. So I sit in this uncomfortable thing with pillows all over it, and it's
a chair pillow.
Yeah, for my back, because if I lean back too much, I'm too far away from my mic and my camera, and like it's all, you would think I would just buy a new chair, but
oh good. I was afraid the pillows were for your butt to stop the leakage from getting rammed every night.
No, that's I've got corks for that. I do have a butt pillow, though. It's like for those wooden chairs, you know, the ones that you're supposed to like tie to wooden chairs. Wooden chairs are bullshit, by the way. But yeah, I've got one of those, and then I got a back pillow. I got, you know, and none of it's comfortable. Like, it's not at all comfortable. It really, a new chair, as much as I sit here, a new chair would just be such a great investment. And I refuse to spend the money.
So you weren't going to get one of those $300 gaming chairs?
No, that's what I need. Like, that's really clearly what I need, is one of those chairs. I was also for a while looking at an X chair. I say looking at it because I was never going to buy it. These are like $1,000 chairs. But, you know, they're not like gaming chairs. They're just like for stupid ass CEOs. Yeah, I do need to get a new fucking chair. It's duct taped. Like, it's really bad. It's garbage. I sit on a pile of garbage.
Yeah. The chairs are important. You know, most of the past year and a half, the places I've been staying, I've been using dining room chairs or living room chairs, and that sucks.
Yeah. Like, a living room chair, not as bad as a dining room chair, though. Because, like, the dining room chair, you got to have, like, that shit, you know, the pillow with the strings on the end tied to it and all of that. Because everybody's had those same chairs. The ones that's, like, oval on the back with the bars on it. And it's just, I don't know where they're from, but they're in every dining room and every fucking poor neighborhood I ever grew up in. Everybody had those stupid chairs. Dining room chairs are the fucking worst.
Yeah, I hit the nadir in Albania, one place I stayed, and had a folding chair. That was really fun.
Oh, man. Yeah. There's no winning. I mean, well, think of this, though. Think about, like, feng shui might actually be, I don't know much about it, but it might actually be something that's important. Is feng shui, like, because, like, I know if I rearrange, because I'm too lazy, if I rearranged, you okay? Did you explode?
I'm good. I just knocked my vape over.
Okay. I thought maybe you shot yourself or something. I'd still publish the fucking episode. I'd just be like, okay, this is fine. But, you know, I don't know if this is what feng shui is or not. I know it's like moving, putting stuff, whatever. I spend so much time and have spent so much time sitting in this shitty chair, and like I really hate the arrangement that I have at the new place. It's a uncomfortable way to do it. Like, my feet, I rest my feet when I'm able to. I rest my feet on beer boxes. just because I don't, you know, I don't want to put them all the way down because that's uncomfortable. So like I put them up like an ottoman, but it's just beer boxes. But the top gets it gets kind of soft after a while, like too dented in, and I just replace them with the new beer boxes.
Bryden is cheap. Spread the word.
Oh yeah, I'm fucking crazy cheap, dude. Yeah, unless it's like closed. Yeah, I'm like crazy cheap. And I haven't even gone clothes shopping in a really long time, which I probably should because I'm fat.
Nah, it's like, you know, not knocking you. I do shit like that all the time. Like, you know, in the dining, you know, when I have to use the dining room table, you know, in certain apartments, I'll just put my feet up on the other chairs.
Yeah, see, that would be better than I'm like locked in this stupid desk the way it's set up because I got to put it against, because it's got the green screen behind me. I mean, it's an absolute nightmare. My old setup was a lot better, and it was pretty rough. That's pretty much the story of me moving to Florida, is things were bad in Ohio, and now I just live in a worse version of it. Like, everything about my life is slightly worse, which is funny, because I just watched Wrist Cutters again today for the first time in a while. You ever seen Wrist Cutters?
I have not.
Great. It's a dark comedy. It's about this guy who kills himself, and he goes to a place. It's this whole other world. It's the same world, exactly the same world, except everybody there is somebody who killed themselves, but everything is exactly the same, just slightly worse. Like if they go on this road trip and all that, I won't, you know, I'll spare you the details, but, If you drop something under the seat of the car, it's just gone forever. Like, you'll just never get it. It's just small stuff like that. Like, people don't smile and all that. It's a really good, it's a really funny movie. It's called Wrist Cutters, a love story. But it's the same world, just slightly worse. And I'm pretty sure I might have fucking killed myself in Ohio.
You know, I've had similar thoughts. I always, you know, part of me thinks that, like, I got fucking murdered in 2014 and everything since then has just been a Jacob's Ladder-esque hallucination.
See, those are the types of things that should be embraced, because the alternative is the cold, harsh reality that we live in interesting times, and it's awful. It's like my lizard people thing. I told you I believe that they're all lizards now because I can't bear to believe that they're humans. You should just believe that you're dead.
Okay, David Icke.
Yeah, well, I told you about the lizard people thing.
I'm not knocking you.
BC alternative to the cold, hard reality that these are just, that people do that? The people are just horrible? Yeah, I choose to believe they're part of some alien race. Thanks.
They came from Anunnaki and were looking for gold.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, something about that. Yeah, I mean, yeah, and then we're like, we were created by them or something to mine gold. I mean, I don't know. Like, Ron Paul aliens sounds like a pretty good bit. I'm really on board for any fucking thing that's not the terrible reality, which is like, actually, you have zero fucking control over your life, and we're done lying and pretending that you do. It's that bad. You know, it's the stuff that, like, in, if there is history books, you know, they'll look back at, like, the way we look back on, like, I can't believe that Germany was that fucked up. It seems like such a nice place now. They'll do the same. It'll be the same thing. America probably won't be around anymore. New York will be. That city is going to last forever. Rome's still around, right? So, you know, it's some of these cities will be around, but I don't know if the country will. And I sure as shit won't. But maybe, Matt, maybe.
A streetcar named Desire. He doesn't want reality. He wants magic.
I just want to die, I think is what it is. I don't even want to die as much as I just don't want to exist, because dying is something that you have to accomplish. I don't like it. Don't like the whole deal, Matt.
You can be like the guy from Planescape Torment who, you know, convinces himself that he doesn't exist anymore and then he just vanishes.
I have never heard of that.
No, it's a good, if you like old school RPGs, it's a good game.
So he's kind of like Yuna from Final Fantasy X? Kind of that old deal?
A bit.
Or like, no, not Yuna, because it was Titus. Yeah, Titus was the one, or Titus, or whatever his name is.
It's like that, but it's like far less gay, and it makes more sense.
Yeah, it didn't really. That's never really made much sense to me. He was a dream or something. I don't really. I wasn't really sure on that one, but it was a fun game.
Yeah, and then there was a. Then there was the sequel where like the real version of him just turned up somewhere.
Yeah, man, I know I asked you this because we were talking about Hideo Kamori. Is like if I found just like a Japanese novel or whatever, is it all written like that weird fucking doesn't make any sense? Like, is that just their culture? Is like they write weird fucking bullshit?
I assume you're referring to Hideo Kojima. And
yeah,
the answer is no. It's just that Kojima sucks.
Right, but whoever wrote the Final Fantasy shit, same thing. Whoever writes any anime ever, same fucking thing. Like, if I were to just find, like, a detective novel written by a Japanese author from, you know, the 80s, would it be that fucking weird?
Well, it depends. I mean, you know, Harumi Murakami's a pretty great novelist, and he writes stuff that's pretty, you know, logical and makes sense.
Murakami doesn't make sense.
Yeah, he does.
Howl's Moving Castle makes fucking sense?
Yes, it does.
Not as much sense as it should make.
Now, Yukio Mishima makes perfect sense.
Yukio, I'm over here and blow me. Yukio, I'm over here and blow me.
He was gay, so he probably would enjoy that.
Well, good. I'm glad we came to an agreement. Fucking good. I'm not trying to be hateful.
He also killed himself in a very dramatic fashion, so that's something else you two could have bonded over.
What did he do?
He tried to launch a coup against the government.
Well, that's not killing yourself. That's just having a bad idea and being murdered.
No. He launched the coup. The soldiers he tried to address just mocked him. So he and his subordinates went into the office and did a whatchamacallit, harakiri. What's the term for it? Yeah, ritual suicide.
Yeah.
But I always like that because like as part of the ritual suicide, like he had to be beheaded. But the guy who was assigned to behead him fucked it up, so it had to be given to someone else. I'd like to imagine Mishima just like sitting there like a fucking like a fucking horror movie with his head half attached to his body. He's like, no, you fuck it up.
Yeah, it's probably pretty hard to cut somebody's head off with a sword. It looks so easy in all those Tarantino films, but I'll bet it's hard.
Yeah, I think one of the other guys also disemboweled himself.
What the hell is wrong with people? There's never been any person that's made any fucking sense. And then you see some like shining lights pop through every now and then. Like Thomas Ligotti. Like, not enough credit goes to that guy. And then he didn't even really touch on the fact that he's like, oh, actually every single person is just fucking terrible. Which I guess, I mean, I don't know if people are necessarily terrible or not. They seem terrible by our own fucking standards, which are fucking made up or whatever. But, like, who the fuck is doing that weird shit? That's weird shit to do, right? Like, to just, like, I'd be like, everybody laughed at me, so I'm gonna go stick a sword in my belly. That's weird, right? That's a weird thing to do.
Well, like the idea was that he didn't really expect the coup to succeed. He was just using it as a pretense to kill himself.
I mean, that's pretty funny.
Like he wanted a big, grand dramatic gesture. You know, shooting himself in his apartment wasn't going to do it. So, like, launch a coup.
See, I think that's bullshit. I think suicide is probably one of the most personal things that you can do. So, I think you'd want to be by yourself when you do it.
Don't live stream it to the world, you know.
Right. You know, why? Why would you want to? I mean, I guess unless like you've never, you know, because I mean, it's not like you and I have done tons of live streams and like been spoken in front of people and, you know, well, you spoke in front of people. I've told jokes, but, you know, like that's the thing. Like we're experienced with that. I guess some people have never done something like that. So maybe that's where that urge comes from. Like, here's my big thing. So I don't know. Like, if you were going to kill yourself, let's say you're, you know, you're done with it all, or for whatever reasons, events have led you to this decision. Where and how would you do it?
I don't know, man. If I killed myself, I'd probably want to make it quick.
Right. So probably like a gun or, you know, you could do.
And I probably, you know, I probably like to, you know, sort shit out beforehand, you know, draw up a will, you know, not tell anyone what I'm
really
gonna do,
but you're one of those. You want to get all of your stuff in order first. Like, you'd clean your apartment up first.
Yeah, clean, you know, it would make it more poignant, I think. You know, see a spotless apartment, then my, you know, corpse just, you know, lying there with blood on the wall, you know? Almost like an art project.
Interesting. Yeah, because, I mean, I know people do that. Like, you know, if somebody has glasses and they jump off of a bridge or whatever, they take their glasses off usually. A lot of them take off their shoes, too, which is interesting. A lot of people take their shoes off before they kill themselves. It's pretty odd. And oddly enough, people don't kill themselves naked a lot, but that's probably because they don't want to be found naked. I mean, they're still going to see your penis.
Yeah, it's like when... It's like when Deadshot himself, he left a note saying apologies for all the blood.
Ah, that's polite, you know. Yeah, it's just that's interesting. See, because like me, when I die, I would prefer to be thrown in the woods to be eaten by animals, because I figure that's the nicest thing to do for the animals. I'm done with it. They can have the meat. So, like, really, what I would do, you know, is go into the woods and do it. Like, deep, deep into the woods. Don't tell anybody. Go to, because then it could be, then you're just a missing person. You know, it could be fucking years before they find your bones, right?
Yeah, it could be a, you know, I mean, it took over a year to find the remains of Steve Fawcett when he crashed his plane.
Well, I saw this video the other day that some guy found some car in a lake in Florida, actually, because he was doing these like bus routes. He was hired by the school to like find the most efficient bus route, and he would use Google Maps to do that. And he was looking at it and he saw this lake and he was like, that looks like a fucking car. And it turns out it was a car from like the freaking 80s, dude. Like, it had been there like 15 years.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, there's a body in there and shit. But you know, I mean, that part's not good. But I would think, you know, it'd be a nice soothing thing around you, the chirping of birds, like not at night, anything, you know, or maybe if night is what I wanted, but like morning dew on everything, the chirping of birds, maybe I put on some music or something like that, something nice and depressing.
You might catch a deer prancing in the distance.
Right. Yeah. And then, you know, you go out like that, it just deep, deep in the woods, because then. You know, because that's, you're not bothered then, you know, and your remains won't be bothered until they've been picked apart by animals who deserve my meat more than I've done with it.
Yeah, you gotta make sure you go real deep though, because otherwise you might be hurt by a hunter.
Right. No, I've thought of all of this for years. I'm more than aware.
I'm not sure whether that's awesome or kind of disturbing, but
it's a thought. It's a thought project. You know, it's something to think. You don't have things that you just think about for years?
No, I've got all kinds of obsessive things I think about. Yeah, but
I wouldn't say it's obsessive. I would just say that I talk about it every chance that I get, and oftentimes at places in which it's not mentioned. I mean, come on, man. Come on. It was something else I wanted to tell you. Forget what it was, though. Oh, well. Wasn't about killing myself, though. It was something really stupid.
Was it something, you know, I assume it was more uplifting.
No, I was mad about it. I just forget what it was.
Probably a good thing for your blood pressure that you did.
Oh, dude, I got high blood pressure. You know that, right?
You mentioned that a year ago, that you, doctor did say you have high blood pressure, and I assume you got that resolved at some point.
Yeah, I haven't done it for a while. I got a Did they get rid of the little arm pumps? Because I know I could check it over there, but I haven't seen one.
Yeah, maybe I've not seen one of those in ages. Well, I've never seen one in Europe, so I mean.
Well, they don't have blood pressure in Europe. They don't, because it's.
I haven't seen one in Mexico either.
Well, everybody in Mexico has high blood pressure. Well, they do. They fucking do. Dude, the amount of sodium that they eat? Oh, my God.
Dude, Mexicans are so fat that every bit of food sold here has, like, huge fucking labels on it. Excess sugar, excess calories, excess sodium, excess caffeine.
Maybe their standards are different, you know, for, like, what is excess or whatever. I'll tell you this. Mexico seems like a fucking dream. I renounce Donald Trump for wanting to build a wall because, like, I think I'm going to Mexico.
Oh no, man! They, you know, the wall should still go up. But yeah, Mexico's
pretty cool. No, because then I'm gonna have to climb over that motherfucker to get into Mexico.
Yeah, you could just take a boat or a plane, like a normal person,
or like all of the ones coming into here.
The ones coming in here aren't Mexicans; they're Guatemalans.
I don't know so much about Guatemala. Hey, what is a pupusa?
A pupusa. Isn't that like a butterfly or like a fucking...
No, it's a food.
Caterpillar or something?
No, it's a food. I know it's some type of Latin food. I know it's not Mexican. I'm just not sure if it's like Cuban or whatever. There's so many different types of... Orlando is a very diverse place. But none of those people are like Irish or Swedish or anything. It's that, you know, it's diversity. So I'm like trying to learn what any of this different shit is.
I never heard of a pupusa, but I just looked it up. It's apparently from El Salvador.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, it looks good, but like, I don't understand exactly what it is. I think it's like bread you put stuff in, which to me, it just seems like, okay, Salvadorian taco. Like, is it like a gordita?
It's a thick griddle cake or flatbread from El Salvador and Honduras, made with cornmeal or rice flour, similar to the Venezuelan and Colombian arepa. It is the national dish of El Salvador.
Well, I mean, yeah, they're super fucking cheap.
Like, you can apparently put anything you want in a pupusa. Like, you know, there's a recipe here for pork pupusas. There's a a butternut squash pupusa. There's a red bean pupusa.
Yeah, I'm going to have to get one of those. So, like, they're just, like, fluffy-ass tacos is really what I'm hearing from this.
Oh, yeah. There's so many variants on tacos in Mexico, too, that's ridiculous. So, it's like pupusa, yeah, there's probably, like, a million different types of pupusas.
Because I don't know, man. Like, so I have been more exposed to, cause like in LA, like, yeah, there were Cubans, but not like this amount. And like, we had like different Latin stuff and that, but it was mainly fucking Mexican, you know? Over here, there's like a whole bunch of different types of Latin shit. And, I'm interested in it, you know? I mean, all of the food looks interesting and shit, but you know, I don't want to accidentally order something that I'm going to hate.
Yeah, I get that. You know, I was eating at a Mexican place the other day, and it's like, you know, they've got like, you know, a million varieties of taco and all kinds of stuff you can put in it. You know, you got carne asada, carne, you know, arribia or whatever it's called. They even had something that translated to lip. Like, you can order a lip taco, which is doesn't sound very appetizing.
Well, like cow lips, because I know they got like rich people eat veal tongue.
Well, veal tongue is a bit different than lip. I mean, maybe it was just a translation, but it didn't sound appealing.
How is it different?
It didn't sound appealing. This wasn't like some super sweet
and veal
place.
Tongue sounds appealing. Tongue.
Well,
there's also tongue tacos because they've got beef tongue tacos. So tongue is appealing
had,
to you,
yeah,
but not the lips.
Yeah, they were offering tongue tacos too. I don't trust a beef tongue from Mexico. Okay, that's just me.
No, how is any of it? How is the tongue different than the lips to you?
Well, I don't like the lips either. I don't like either one of them.
I'm just saying, I'm just saying, it's the same thing. And one is considered, you know, good. I don't know. I mean, like, as long as they're not be like, here, it's a cow tooth taco. Yeah, I wouldn't want the cow tooth. Seems a little too crunchy. But yeah, tongue and lips, it seems like not that big of a deal.
I don't know. Maybe I'll eat it at some point. Maybe it's actually really good. I don't know. But the way the menu read, it didn't sound very appealing to me at all.
Well, I don't know. You ever had a Slim Jim before?
I have.
Yeah, you've eaten cow lips.
I know. But,
the butt lips, know, too. The butt lips, too. Not the front lips. The butt lips.
Yeah, I mean, I figured you were going to make a joke about hot dogs here.
No, I mean, most hot dogs that anybody's actually going to buy are going to be like 100% good, not butthole hot dogs. Because, like, if you're still buying dollar hot dogs, look, I can buy a pack of hot dogs for $1. I mean, like, that's just all butts and organs. Like, you don't want that. You got to get the good ones.
It's lips and tallywhackers, as someone once described it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's true. I mean, I don't know. The effect, look, I don't go hard on this very often on this show, but I'm feeling like I need to do it today. You need to fucking look at the shit that you're eating in your goddamn meat, because I swear to God, it's nothing but a bunch of chicken anuses. That's what's in there. And you know what? You know, it's not just the anuses, it's also the poop. All right? You're eating a lot of poop. You're a bunch of poop eaters, you blood mouth motherfuckers. Stop eating goddamn meat. It's horrible. Not only is it gross, I know it tastes delicious, but not only is it fucking gross because it's buttholes, it's also mean. Okay, look at your cat or your dog or your lizard or whatever you fucking freaks that listen to this pot. Your snake, you little psychopaths out there with snakes. Look at that pet and then go, would I eat that motherfucker? No. And if you would eat it, you need to go and give your friend a peck because you're fucking real bizarre and I don't trust you with animals.
Well, there's a difference, you know. Cats and dogs are, you know, they're our fluffy friends, you know. Cows are not.
Why? People are friends with cows. They're friendly animals. Why? No, it's all context. Don't condemn the Chinese for fucking eating dogs and be like, what monsters? And they're like, oh, Indians are so fucking weird because they don't eat that. No. All of this is weird fucking cultural shit. And really, the rule should be, you probably shouldn't eat him. He's like, seems like he's having a good time. You know, really, really, especially, you know, the fucking like yuppie pieces of shit in the city who are like, oh, I get my farm raised chicken, my farm rake, free range cows, free range this and that. If anything, that's worse because those animals were just having a normal, happy life and somebody came up and killed them. At least the ones in slaughterhouses are fucking miserable. Kill those motherfuckers.
Brian's reasonable and intelligent defense of factory farming.
Well, it's true. Stop kidnapping them and breeding them and all of that shit. That's great. But like, if we got to kill any of the cows first, do the ones that are fucked. Those are miserable animals. Oh, I get everything free range. So you mean he was just living a chicken life before somebody came up and lopped his fucking head off? That's worse. It's fucking worse. There's no defense for eating it. Besides, I just like it. And the thing is, if you just like it, that's the same as people watching Stephen fucking Colbert and be like, I just like it. I'm like, no, you're slowly being indoctrinated into this bullshit. Eating meat is fucking wrong. I need to stop eating eggs and cheese. I really do. I used to not eat it. I need to stop doing it. But, I mean, give me a fucking break here. If you're going to eat animals, eat the factory farm ones. They're miserable.
There's even an article that was once published in Return to Kings on how to, you know, buy a pet pig and kill it to make carne asada or whatever the fuck it is. One of the tips was that before, on the day that you slaughter it, you know, your little pet pig, get it drunk beforehand so it doesn't freak out. And then you take it into the shower and then you just smack it in the head with a plumber's wrench.
I'm going to find that article and replace pet pig with toddler and see the fucking outrage. You know, I don't know.
It also advocates scaring the pig before the pig beforehand because not scaring it because like the fear, you know, makes the meat taste worse.
Yeah. No. Whatever. I'll write a whole article on the utilitarian argument for factory farming. It'll be a that's actually a nice satire piece, honestly. That sounds really funny. But no, it's just I don't want to hear any of this fucking, oh yeah, they're cage free. Oh, you actually know what cage free is? Yeah, the fucking Heinz company is really doing cage free eggs in their mayonnaise. Look up what cage free looks like. Stop trying to lie to yourself, acting like you're a good fucking person. You can't be mad about people eating dogs when you have a dog if you're doing any of this. It's stupid. And this is a belief I've held for years because of just the irrationality of it. Like, things have to be consistent, Matt, because otherwise I fucking spaz out and it doesn't make any sense.
Well, I'm going to get a pet dog and I'm going to keep eating meat.
That's fine. I mean, oh, like on a moral issue, like I don't really give a shit. I'm not a dog or anything. I'm a different type of meat. You know, if you start eating people, then that's between you and law enforcement. That's, you know, I'm not that meat. I'm not that meat that you ate. If you eat me, then we got a beef. But did you see what I did? But, you know, it's, ugh. I don't know. It's just an annoying thing. It's just, it's such an annoying fucking thing. What I really don't like, Matt, I think, is that people are so proud of themselves for existing, and it annoys me. It annoys the shit out of me. I should be Catholic, because I think that everyone should live in just abject shame of their own existence at all times.
So what you're saying is we shouldn't go around acting like we're awesome for being born?
Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, it's my birthday. It's my birthday. Yeah. Okay, great. Two people had sex, and then now you're here being loud at the bar. Holy shit. Let's get you a cake? What? Why? Why are we baking goods? Because two people fucked 30 years ago.
You can also become a Jehovah's Witness. They don't celebrate birthdays.
Oh, that's the part I like so much about them. They don't celebrate any holidays. Because, like, why do we say that a holiday is special? Like, we call it a holiday or whatever. You know that March 1st is the first day of Women's Month, right? Women's History Month, right?
There's a Women's History Month?
Apparently, yeah. It's a UK thing. I guess it's, like, starting over here. I had never heard of it before, but it's when I looked on Google, the first official one is 2022. Not sure if that's a typo, but it is in their Google calendar. So we got Black History Month. We got Women's History Month.
We got LGBT Month.
That's in June, yeah. It's June or July. Do you remember? I don't remember.
It's June. And there's probably an Indigenous Peoples Month.
Probably. I mean, do you remember when it was a fucking... When it was a week? Pride Week? Now it's Pride Month? I don't know what that's all about. Black people been struggling for fucking years. They get 1 month. You would think they would move up to, like, maybe they get, you know, it's fucking Black History Quarter. Like, give them 3 months at the beginning of the year. Fucking Pride Month. It's Pride Month now instead of Pride Week.
Soon enough, it'll be Pride Year.
Yeah, but again, where are black people in this? They're still just stuck with the shortest month. I say give Black History Quarter. If we're going to give fucking LGBTQIA2SA, say, whatever, whatever it is, a week to a month in my lifetime, I say we give fucking Black History Quarter. First quarter, Black History Month, or Black History Quarter. I think that's fair.
Yeah, you know, I wouldn't object to that.
I mean, you know, as long as everybody's all moving up and they're fucking expanding their time on the calendar, give black people Black History Quarter. Whole quarter.
But I guarantee you that, Pride Decade is going to happen before Black History Quarter.
Ew, but you know what? It won't actually outwardly be about gay people. It'll be about pride in the human race, and it'll be the what they call, like, the foundation of the new world government. The pride, the decade of pride, or they'll call it something like that. I mean, we'll both be dead, so it's whatever. But Oh, yeah, man. Some of the, for some reason, every day the Left Behind movies are becoming real. It's rough.
Yeah, it's not gonna be. It's not gonna be great. It's not gonna be. Not gonna be fun.
I'm gonna go piss, and then we're gonna finish out the other half hour if that's fine with you.
Let's just end the show now.
It's Boo! Leave a comment below for Matt for ending the show. Tell Matt that you think it is lame that he ended the show.
Nah, I got shit to do. So like
He is withholding things from your day, which is, I'm sure it's filled with so much productivity. Anyone that's listening to this, wow, you're really getting stuff done, aren't you? Wow, yeah, you're really fucking, you're getting things done. Actually, I just put it on in the background. You know, I'm like, I'm doing things. They say as they're sifting through Twitter, you dumb fucking faggots.
They're looking up interracial cuck porn.
That would be more productive. At least that's, you know, would be stimulating versus what they're doing, which is not even reading tweets. They're looking at them, waiting to see their own tweet to see how many, you know, like as if the notifications aren't at the top of the screen.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The guy is looking at interracial cuck porn. He's adjusting the volume so that our voices are just above the sound of the cuck crying in the corner.
No, they can still hear you.
But yeah, we do need to end the show. Brian, anything you want to plug?
Longer shows. Chant at home, ladies and gentlemen. Remember to send all of your complaints to was at Terrorhouse Mag on Twitter. Send all of your complaints. And remember, the more direct you are about personal appearance, the better. Also, yeah. I live stream sometimes, but not going to for a while. I'm on a break because I'm writing a novel about being Matt Forney's fucking sister.
That'll be exciting, I'm sure. But yeah, go check Brian out on Trovo and DLive and his website, BrianProctor.com. All those links will be in the description. You can find me at MattForney.com, and my shit will be in the description as well. And that'll do it for this episode of Terror House Radio. Be sure to check Terror House Magazine, TerrorHouseMag.com, every day for our latest publications. Books are at TerrorHousePress.com. Broken Uterus by Kai Jantan is out now. Follow our social media links in the description. And you can always find new episodes of Terror House Radio, the latest episodes, at TerrorHouseRadio.com. Terror House Radio is produced by Bryden Proctor and presented by Jugs. Intro music by Meme Extremist. Illegitimate Non-Coverundum. Don't let the bastards grind you down. I'm Matt Forney. Thanks for watching, everyone, for listening. We are out.